come buy this car. Oh, it runs great. You know, he didn't even sell it like that, though. He just said, you want his mattress? It's a good mattress. It's a good one. That's like me talking to you over the phone about, like, how nice is your car? I'm like, oh, it's nice. Like, you should come, you know. Oh, okay. Oh, I'll pay for it right now with my credit card.
Aaron, this week.
But then he comes to me and he's like, do you want some kind? Or he's like, he goes, if you come out and work in the garden tomorrow, he's like, I'll give you this cotton. He's like, I'll show you how to make a mattress. And I'm like, oh, dude, don't worry about it. I was like, I don't need the cotton. I was like, but I'll come work out in the field still. I was like, I don't know if you need me to come work out there. See, I didn't go work out there today because he didn't come ask me to do it. If he would have came and like, hey, Taylor, will you come work out? I'm like, yeah, let me grab my shit and I'll go out there. But like you said, I don't see the fucking point. And if he would have, see, that's the irritating thing is like, he considers me a negative person. Did he consider you a negative person before he talked to you?
I don't know. I would assume, yeah. I would assume.
I mean, since we all hang out. But it's like, why don't you approach me? You know, as the person that he says he is, why don't you come approach me? And just like, I'm an open-minded person. And guess what? The way I've talked to him before, and the way his whole philosophy on like talking to people is, it's like, good or bad, come approach me. Find out what I'm really about.
Mm-hmm.
If I'm like, yeah, bro, go fuck yourself. How about that? Then you got your answer. This dude's a prick. Fuck him. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But if you come at me, you walk around and you explain how he explained you, you know, aside to it, like you said, I mean, as funny as it is, dude, like, you probably have the most, like, the loudest voice in here that people follow. You know what I'm saying? But I think I'm like I'm a second person to that. You know what I mean? Like, I'm a hard worker. Where we have a loud voice is, we back it by what we do. Yeah, we don't bring any money in for this place. But guess what? There's nobody that works harder here than we do. You know what I'm saying? In a sense, because realistically, we work like an hour a day or whatever.
I wish there was more shit that I could get behind. I don't. To me, that's a waste of energy.
That's what
because
I'm saying.
For me, it's not going to feed everybody. Okay, it's not going to make any money. It's just out there. It's just a sweat burner.
Yeah.
It's just, I'm going to go out there and I'm going to do this and I'm going to sweat. To me, I'm like, fuck that thing. Let's just buy some cans of vegetables and call it a day.
Yeah.
It's 10 days till November.
But so what's his point by getting us in there? Does he think
just to get people to work together?
People will come in there and work with us?
Just to get to work together. You know what I'm saying?
But the thing about him too is, bro, it's like, fuck, at least like express that to more than like a few people. Like, Hex is feeling betrayed. Like, he could at least go up to her and explain the situation of what's going on. You know what I mean? Like,
Hex should have gave that up.
Oh, for sure. She
like a while ago, she should have gave it up because like things, like she started bargaining for stuff, but then it just like took a back seat to other things.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So she couldn't really like hold on to it. Yeah. It was just too much.
Well, she wanted to be in charge of two things, which she makes. I mean, look at she's done with. I know you want to like kind of like dismiss all the businesses and work on one large project. But realistically, like, we're going to have to grow some income to back a big project.
She's done a lot.
Yeah,
no
for
doubt.
Sure.
She's done a lot.
For sure.
But that's what I was thinking. Like, she said she crunched some numbers and it costs like $3,700 a month.
Yeah.
For us to be here.
Yeah.
That's a lot of money.
Dude.
That's a ton of money.
Well, that was her averaging in $20 a week.
Yeah.
For all of us personal money, which is damn, like, we should. That's bare minimum in my eyes. You know what I'm saying?
That's a lot of money, a lot of loot.
But it's not like impossible at the same time. But dude, for what we're trying to pull off, I mean, we're gonna have to plan like $6,000 to $8,000 a month.
Yeah.
But I mean, fuck, dude, 15 people.
We can do that. We can pull in $8,000 a month by something.
That's not saying 15 people. Like, we should eat like $1,000 a person is $15,000. You know what I'm saying? Is that?
I just want to do it together.
Yeah, no, and I agree with that. And that's the whole point to this. But at the same thing, like, I'm kind of curious. Well, like, you know, I'm kind of curious on what the chicken coop's plan is. Because, I mean,
don't even talk about that.
No, I know. I'm just saying, I know we need some direction, but at the same time, I don't want to be, like, fed an idea. I want to come up with that ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
At this point, we need to get direction. We need to all come together and have a direction. I just think that the minds in there, I think there's a lot of minds in there who want this. Like, I think Nikki wants this, but can we talk her into, like, doing one thing? I don't know.
Like, dropping yoga completely?
Like, can we talk her in? And maybe we can.
No. I think she would be willing to give up her yoga class. I mean, it would be tough. I really do. But I think she would need, and you would have to break on this too, bro. She would need. Old boy's garden. Yeah, that's one more thing that everybody comes together and does. But if we slowly start to do these things, man, if we slowly start to do group activities, it's only a matter of time till the business thing is a group activity as well. Yeah. We all got it. And you know what? As much as Josh has said, I want to do everything. I want to be in the barn. I want to. Tomorrow, man, I know he's got his boxes, but fuck it. When we go in there, be like, hey, Josh, come work in the garden with us just for an hour. We should see how many people we can really get out there. And you know what? Fuck friendships at this point. The people that deny the fact, and you know what? Even Aaron, for one, if he denies it tomorrow, I'll put a vote in for him. I love the dude. I think he's awesome. But if he says no to working out in the garden when we're all out there, he's not cooking tomorrow. He's not cooking dinner. He's not cooking breakfast. He has nothing to do. Mm-hmm. If he has the balls to deny coming and working out there for, you know what I mean? I don't care if any of us see anything happening in that. But it's like old boy said, it's more like proving a point at that point. You know what I'm saying? Like show that you're here for a bigger reason than, like, because I mean at this point, dude, Aaron could be here to show off his cooking skills on a TV show and that's it. Mm-hmm. Fucking Bonnie can marketing thing. Hex, I won't even. She's here for all the right reasons. So
she is here for the right reasons.
But fucking Josh, he could be here for a fuck. Before.
Yeah, I've heard that too.
You know what I mean? Me, I'm here for a life experience. I don't really have I didn't have a big, you know, help the world plan behind mine. Mine was just like, this would be cool. I don't have like a business I'm trying to start or anything like that. You, I feel like you're right on the page with me. Like we mainly came here for, mm-hmm. to get our lives a little bit farther ahead without fucking, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Which there's nothing wrong with that. But I think since you and I have been here, that weird feeling has grown in the pit of our stomachs and in the deep part of our minds where, no, I want to be here for a bigger reason.
Yeah,
than that
exactly.
Now, you know what I mean?
And like, that's why I get angry.
I want to leave and I want people to come up to me and be like, you did make a difference, dude. Like, mm-hmm. you made a difference. And that's truly how I want to feel when I walk there. Money or not money, no money. Like, I don't care at this point. Like, I just want to leave and people come up to me and be like, wow. Like, I want to make a legacy.
I tell you, I felt like kicking the balls today when I didn't get 14 people saying, yeah, let's give Thanksgiving to someone else.
I was right there with you. That didn't make any sense. I mean, I think you came at it strong. Like, dude, I love vets. You love vets. You're in the military. There's a couple other
It guys. Could be anything. It could
but
be anybody.
But yeah, I think that's kind of where you lost people, though, is saying the vet thing. Because that's such a common, like, I think personally, bro, in it. Like personally,
I was thinking like old people.
Old people or like
older
you said, special.
That's what I was thinking about.
Yeah. Someone I wanna give back to somebody that eats, like you said, someone that's alone. Someone that's alone on Thanksgiving. Someone that doesn't know what it feels like to have their family with them or family mm-hmm. around them. Like that would be like a giant support system for I wouldn't even eat. It wouldn't bother me. You know what I'm saying? Like I would feel gratified at making dinner. And just enjoying the conversation with these people, you know what mm-hmm. I'm saying? Like, that would be enough for me.
Like, sit down with an old person, you will learn so much cool shit. Oh, they may think they don't have anything to say, but when they start talking, like, everybody has a story. Everybody has
so many cool stories.
Everybody has a story, you know what I'm saying? So, like, when I'm 15 or 14 people being like, yeah, let's do us and this and that, I'm like, fuck, forget us. Yeah. What is it's us? Like, like, don't be so selfish.
Well, my thought, when that all started getting said, dude, my first thought is, sweetheart, you got one more year, and you're going to be Thanksgiving with your own fucking family. Like, give back, you know what I mean?
Yeah, we got 12 months.
Like, who cares? You're going to lose one Thanksgiving out of your entire life. Not even lose, but you know what I'm saying? Like,
you would feel better doing something for someone. You would feel so much better.
Oh, yeah. Like, oh, then we should have two Thanksgivings. Like, no, fuck two. Who cares? Like, I love you guys, but guess what? We spend every fucking day together.
Yeah.
What the fuck is one? We eat dinner together every day. What is this one? It's in the name. Yeah. Giving.
Let's go get another bottle of wine.
It's in the name. It's like giving back, you know?
Yeah.
Like, my parents would be way more proud of me if I'm, you know, making dinner for a large group of people that are going to be just blown away by just having a good conversation. Like, you know, they're not looking for handouts. They're looking for good conversation.
Yeah. Company. Something like that.
You know, the funny thing is, man, I think that's why I kind of am a really good person. Is growing up, one of my elementary school teachers had a daughter that was special needs.
Oh, yeah.
So we would take a field trip every week to work with the kids.
My closest cousin.
And we would take a field trip every week to go work with her daughter and the people her daughter was, like the class her daughter was with. And then, like, when I got older, my fifth grade class, we would take a trip once a week to old folks' home, and we kind of had pen pals with the old folks. So, is this all done?